I think this debate is in some ways the most anticipated political event of certainly this year. You could argue really the last 5 or 10 years. We know both these folks. We know Joe Biden. We know Donald Trump. We know the good. We know the bad. We're going to see if we see the ugly on stage, right? So I think for Joe Biden, clearly, fairly or unfairly, there are questions about his mental fitness for office, whether he is too old or not. So I think he's going to want to sort of project some vitality in a way that other candidates don't need to. For Donald Trump, again, fairly or unfairly, the knock here is going to be, can we trust this guy? Is this guy somebody who will stay within the lanes? Can he trust him to be president of the United States? And so I think he's going to have to certainly talk about that as well. So I think the goals for each are slightly different. As far as what it might mean electorally, I mean, it could mean a lot. We know that debates in general don't really determine the outcome of the election unless an election is incredibly close. An election is incredibly tight. And that's the kind of election we're looking at here. There's just a few states that are going to matter. There's just a few voters within those states. And so I think this could be one of the rare debates that really does get watched and really does affect the outcome. I think to some degree, both of them have a tremendous amount to lose and a tremendous amount to gain. I mean, these are not people who come in with unblemished records. Both of them have their detractors, even within their own party, much less across parties, much less with independent voters. So I think really this one matters for both candidates. And I think that's what makes it a unique debate. That and the fact that these are one incumbent and one person who sort of acts like an incumbent. We just don't have much of a script for this in American politics. So the usual thing we say is, hey, debates are a blip in the radar screen. Debates don't really matter. Debates don't really affect the outcome. I think this may be the exception to that rule. I think for Donald Trump and Joe Biden, they both need to reach the unaffiliated voter, the independent voter, and then they need to shore up their own base. I mean, Donald Trump clearly has some questions from the Republican Party about whether after the conviction, he is worthy to be in office. He needs to shore that up. He needs to be able to have an answer. And for Joe Biden, clearly, a lot of the Democrats aren't real happy with him right now on Israel-Palestine, as well as a number of other events. So they need to speak to multiple audiences, that independent voter, that swing voters, that small number of people who are undecided, and at the same time shore up their base. That's a difficult recipe, right? Because one message that tends to do well for one of those audiences may fail with the other. We're moving to the assumption that they will be the nominees for their party. I think that's a safe assumption. Almost certainly it will be Donald Trump versus Joe Biden. But we are in some uncharted territory, right? We're in some uncharted waters. These are people with very, very, very high negatives. So I expect them both to get out of the conventions. I expect the conventions to be coronations like usual. But is there the smallest chance that something could happen between now and the convention, either due to age or due to a different decision from the party? Yeah, I think that's out there this year in a way it never has been before. Now that's, you know, 3, 4, 5% chance. Very, very small. But there is a chance, and that is unique and different.